Boys coming back at you guys, going over the hill and far away, targeting striped bass, bluefish, fluke, and whatever else is biting. I'm meeting up with Johnny out here this weekend in Long Island. We're doing a camping adventure, get on these fish. We're fishing incoming tide, outgoing tide. The tide doesn't matter because we are sending it. Hope you guys like the video.
Yo, look who it is.
Back your shit up, let's go.
Yo, what's good, bro?
Let's go.
I'm about to catch one here though, man.
Go.
All right, I'm coming. I'll meet you there.
All right, Johnny called. I came in all Tom Sawyer and Huck Finn with the complete outfit.
Dude, who's who? Who's Tom Sawyer and who's Huck Finn? I think you're definitely... I wish I was more of the Huck Finn, but you're definitely more of the Huck Finn.
You think so, dude?
I'm more of the Tom Sawyer. I'm trying to think. The conniving, is that the word? Or
yeah, that's
the sleazy
it, that's it.
Type. The sleazy outdoorsman.
Johnny's and just a
kid,
sender.
This kid comes in like just... Sometimes I really wonder what's going on in this kid's head because he's literally just straight sending. He doesn't know any other way to live. So let's just give a rundown. I'll give a rundown of my materials. I've got the old bass shoes. These have gone through a little bit. They're going to be used on the send today. We've got dinner. Got a 5-star gourmet dinner.
And that's
seeds. We're going to mix the pumpkin seeds in with the dry roasted peanuts.
Sounds
pretty
good.
Homemade recipe.
We got to mix some striped bass in
there.
Here's
the striped bass in there, though.
Ooh, all right.
Oh.
So these clams I got right before we went on our trip to the Skills.
Yeah.
And I put them in the fridge. So honestly, they're like, yo, they're still alive.
Actually,
they're still shut.
They're just in that cooler?
They're just in the cooler for like 3 or 4 days in the fridge, but they're like,
yo.
They're like shut. Like, this is fresh clam. And we got this, dude. We got
the surf rod.
My buddy Chris, who I've really barely met. Chris lent me the surf rod, dude.
Yeah, what is that, 11 feet?
It's 12 foot Altenkirch Precision. Dude, the guys at Haskell's asked me if this was the rod because I was like, I got this custom one piece 12 foot rod.
Yeah.
The guy said that there used to be a guy out on the island who made them. He doesn't make them anymore.
No
way.
So
this is like apparently like a legendary setup we got right here.
What?
So this is what we're going to pair with the spike.
Oh, no way.
So what I'm thinking is we're going to hike out on this island. We're going to camp. We're going to spike one of these up with the clams and then we're going to go for our walk.
Yeah.
Keep an eye on it, kind of.
Just let
or maybe
it sit
this
there.
Is what we use when we're kind of chilling and setting up.
Exactly.
We'll cast
yeah.
this out while we're setting up.
Is there a channel right where we're camping?
Yeah.
Hey,
and then,
right.
dude, so I got this my nighttime setup. I got all the baits in the green bag.
Sick.
And I think we're ready to go. Here's your reel today, dude.
Oh, thank you so much, dude. Shout out to that.
This is.
That's perfect.
This is good, right?
Oh, perfect. Thank
Boom.
You so much.
That's for your rod.
Hey, all right.
And all right, dude, let's get out.
Yo, let's freaking let's do this. Sending.
All right, dude, let's keep on sending.
So I gotta just figure out how to get to that island.
Yo, like who else is doing this? That's my question.
I'm glad I brought the change of pose.
Yeah.
Dude, I came out at medium tide.
Oh, over here is just getting deeper. I mean, we might be able to make this. This is just making it that much sicker, though. Oh, oh my god, I just stepped on a horseshoe crab. Dude, I have no shoes on. Oh, that was the perfect depth. Any deeper, we couldn't have done that.
Down here.
Dude, honestly, we should, like, I've caught fluke and these are like flats here. It gets shallow.
So we just walk way out.
I don't know what we do. Let me throw some gulp on so I'm ready to cast.
Got the X-Rab tied on. We got Johnny for the guide, waiting the sod banks and the dunes for striped bass, bluefish, fluke, whatever's biting. That's
that
perfect.
Actually looks pretty fucking good.
So you got the search bait. I've got the bluefish striper.
Bluefish bait.
Oh yeah.
I don't know. We kind of got it going right now, honestly.
I'm so hyped.
I mean,
I guess the question is, since we still have light, where's the best place to fish, you think, to start fishing?
Dude,
try
I mean,
out new water?
I know that there's a channel there. It gets deep, but like, I kind of want to scout out. I've just never been back here.
Yeah.
So like, I don't know. We know we can catch fish back there.
Exactly.
We
so I guess we'll
we
do that during the
night.
All right, perfect.
So we might as well see what's back here. No
Sounds
one,
like
no
a plan.
One comes back here ever.
Only the birds. That's what I love to see.
Like, I think it stays shallow. And then, like...
I mean, shallow doesn't mean bad, though.
Shallow's not a bad
No.
Like,
honestly, it probably means more little bait fish. So I'd imagine like maybe more fish are in here, just not the big ones are probably out in the main channel. I'm not like that good at saltwater fishing.
I don't know what I'm doing either. So that's why it's kind of interesting.
Dude, these birds though
amaze me. Yeah, there's like, so many.
Look at all. Oh, don't we have a little channel over here that we saw that we crossed
that
over?
That we crossed. Like, yeah. Is there fish in those? There's gotta be, right?
Honestly, dude, just from freshwater fishing, I started to realize that fish are everywhere and they do things that people don't even know of.
Yeah.
So with saltwater, imagine that. This is the entire ocean. It connects to every place else in the world. The fish are all over.
The fish are all over.
People just don't know. Like, dude, like we were talking about all those houses, these people, like, I mean, okay, you got some senders over there, but how many of them fish?
Dude, I don't know any of those are senders. Because if you're a sender, you just don't need a house like that.
You'll be camping out here, which
and,
is
like,
even
you
better.
You don't have time to make that kind of money if you're a sender.
Exactly.
Because if you're making that kind of money, you're not sending it.
Exactly.
Like, I don't know what to tell you, dude. Money's just not that cool. Like, it's kind of lame. Or it means like you're doing a lot of bullshit all the time.
All we need is rod.
Look at this, dude.
Look at the amount of birds that just trek through this. Birds are badass. Let's scout it out, and then I guess we're just gonna work this way towards the channel. Find the fish. Seems like a lot of the guys are fishing down there, but also they're getting skunked.
I already know that spot.
Yeah.
It's an obvious spot. I don't know back here.
I kind of think that they're gonna be fish here. You wanna just start walking out and start wading down?
Yeah, I just don't know, like, it's gonna get cold. We do have to be a little cautious that we are gonna be out here for a while and it's gonna get way colder.
So what are your thoughts to that? Just don't go that deep?
I'm thinking, like, maybe not, like, past, like our thighs.
Okay, dude, I'd say,
interesting.
Let's walk out knee deep in the water somewhere that way.
Get to where it's deep.
Yeah, and let's just start casting. I have the X-Wraps on.
It happened.
Yeah, it's kind of what we do.
Right? That's how you, that's what I've learned, dude. That's kind of just how to fish.
Oh my god, dude. Insane. In the membrane. Dude, fish, they do really like the shallow water. You feel how much warmer this is than the water we were walking through before? I might be wrong, but it does feel pretty warm. I'm hitting bottom hard out there. It's all a matter of if we want to fish shallow water and grind it out for a little bit. Or just send it to the channel and just start ripping that.
I think we're going to end up sending it to the channel. I just feel like explore this way. Just to kind of see if we find anything.
Well, dude, how have we found our craziest fishing spots?
Just by exploring.
Just doing this.
Dude, what if we do this? Like, what if we like walk the marsh kind of, like in that
okay,
way?
Yeah.
And then just hit the sand from there. You know, just like.
Okay.
Or we could walk by the chips. Kind of up to you. Kind of like both.
I was just going to say, I kind of like
fishy this honestly feels. Like, I don't know about you, but like that.
Well, the only thing is, dude, with saltwater, I feel like, dude, like the amount of baitfish I see in the shallows like this, it makes me think that there are just a ton of fish that people just don't
that
catch.
Get overlooked.
Yeah. We know freshwater gets overlooked, and that's like, how much of the world is freshwater? 3%? 3 fucking percent?
Yeah. We're not fishing salt.
Salt is sick.
We're not fishing this enough.
I kind of just want to take my kayak one day and just like go like 100 miles
just
eating fish and like, yeah. Blue right back.
Roll, baby.
This guy's spitting up clams.